Hello viewers, welcome to another session in mathematics. I hope the coronavirus has not taken you out of focus. With the limited time, we are going to look at 10 major topics tested in KCPE mathematics. And our first topic today will be in the topic area. Area is the space bound by lines. We have got different geometrical shapes in which the examiner in KCPE will ask in maths. One is a triangle. In a triangle, by now, we have the main fact or concept. We have the formula a half times base times perpendicular height. The base and the perpendicular heights are the major variables which gives you the area. The examiner will not always come and ask that simple class 5 question, area of a triangle like this, where you are given the base is 8 and the height is 6 centimeters, such that your work will directly be to put substitute the variables inside there and get the area. The examiner by now has reached a level where he requires deeper thinking in your calculation, bearing that the fact, the concept is all has already sunk in your mind. The examiner will come and produce a line here. Like that, we have triangle A with a B there and a D there. He asks you, find the area of triangle ACD. Before you ask yourself what is area there, you have to look at the triangle and see the variables he has given you. For example, you're given here, this is 13 centimeters. We are given from point A to B is 9 centimeters. From 9 centimeters there, you are given that this side is 15 centimeters. He asks you, what is the area of that triangle? From the concept there, we take our variables. Remember, area of a triangle is a half times base times perpendicular height. If you look at this triangle, we have our perpendicular height there, DB. We have our base, AC. But none of the variables is given. In such a question, the examiner requires you to use another concept. And the concept we use here, they are not two, it's only one. We use the Pythagorean relationship so that we can get the perpendicular height DB, and we also get the portion BC, which is not given. When we look at that triangle, we recognize that triangle ABD is a rectangled triangle. Using Pythagorean relationship, it will give us the height up there, which is the perpendicular height of the triangle. From the triangle DBC, after we have got the height here, we have the hypotenuse there, we can now get BC. And therefore, you come using Pythagoras relationship, which says A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared, where A is the adjacent, B is the base, and C is the hypotenuse. So AB, which is 9 centimeters, is our base. So 9 squared plus DB, which is our adjacent, we are not given, should equal to 15 squared. Our algebra dictates here, our unknown there shall be 15 squared minus 9 squared. This goes to 225 less 81. So our unknown there is equal, which is squared, unknown is squared there, unknown is squared, this comes to 144. Then we find the square root of all that, our unknown, which was a question mark, becomes 12. So we have got our perpendicular height here is 12 centimeters. With now 12 and 13, we can get BC, since BC squared again should equal to BC squared minus DB squared. So BC squared is equal to DC squared, which is 13 squared minus 12 squared. So here we have 169 less 144, and therefore B squared is equal to 25. When you find the square root of that, BC shall equal to 5 centimeters. Now we have got this time 5 centimeters, which gives us now our base 9 plus 5, which is 14. So we substitute this formula, a half times base is 14 centimeters times height, which is 12. So if you look at this question, the variables that will enable us to get the area were not directly given. They were indirectly given, and therefore you had to use another concept on Pythagoras' theorem to get the dimensions and hence they get the area. So it is at this juncture you should be prepared to look at the variables given in every question and the question which is asked. As I put stop.